Hey guys, Sorin here. So let's talk about megabytes per second versus megabits per second. When we usually sign up for a new internet contract via one ISP, let's say telecom, we see that we have speeds advertised like 100 megabits per second. It's the M with the BPS in lowercase. Well, you see that and you might expect 100 megabytes per second transfer rates, but that's not the case. It's just a different way of expressing internet or networking speed. So we have bytes and bits. We usually think in bytes when we mean I have a 1 terabyte, notice the byte, hard drive, or a 512 gigabyte SSD. But manufacturers, and I mean also ISPs, but manufacturers also, like router makers, switch makers, networking cards makers, refer in bits. So we see a motherboard that has an integrated network adapter that is capable of 1 gigabit per second. That's gigabits. The bit is the smallest unit to measure data. A byte has 8 bits. So when we see a 100 megabits internet connection speed or networking speed, we don't have 100 megabytes per second. We actually have 100 divided by 8, because as I said, a byte has 8 bits. So we actually get about 12.5 or something like that megabytes per second with a 100 megabits internet connection. That's not false advertising, that's not really lying to us, it's just the way they measure speed is not how we are used to refer as speed. So when you're going to download something with a 100 megabits internet connection, your maximum speed will actually theoretically be about 12.5 megabytes per second. Well, that's pretty hard to reach. It depends on the download server location, your PC, who else is on your network active at that moment, and many other factors. But that's the theoretical maximum output of that internet connection. So next time, when shopping for a router, a switch, or trying to upgrade your ISP, keep this in mind. They usually talk in bits. We like to talk in bytes. So if they say you're going to have a 1 gigabit per second internet connection, divide that by 8 to find out the maximum theoretical, realistical speed you can get, as we like to use it. I hope this short video was useful and you found out why we sometimes feel like we are deceived by manufacturers and ISPs, but we are really not. They just use another unit of measurement. And if you did, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, give this video a like, and tell me what other kind of short videos like this would you like to see in the future. Thanks for watching. Bye.